This is garbage. Today, I'm gonna try and make something useful out of this garbage. But I'm not alone. The awesome Australian creator over at the YouTube channel I Did A Thing reached out to me a while ago. Together, we decided to see who could make the most useful thing out of garbage. Now, while most of you know me for my ability to repurpose items from Goodwill and Craigslist, this isn't actually my first time working with literal garbage. Like the time that I made the radio control can of beans, or when I've used cardboard and foam to help my microphones sound better, or that time that I had to make that remix of a Nickelback album. We decided to keep the rules simple. We needed to use items that were found in the trash bin. Okay, more specifically, items that were meant to be thrown away or recycled. We could also use fasteners like zip ties, or hot glue, or duct tape.
The first project I attempted was turning a cat litter container into a water pump.
There's some holes in the bottom of the bin with balloons stretched over the top. This acts like a one-way valve. Air or water could go in, but it can't come out. There's also some holes in the top of the bin that have a one-way valve where air can go out, but not go in. I cut some trash bag to make a bladder for the lid. When you pull the lid up, it creates a vacuum that will suck air or water through the bottom of the bin, and then when you push down on the lid, it will push the excess air out the top of the lid. In this way, you could set it in a puddle of water and pump it up and down, and it would fill with water, and you could carry it and dump it out somewhere. Unfortunately, my holes were probably too small, and it was very difficult to secure the balloons, and I basically ended up making the world's crappiest accordion.
Instead of trying to improve the design, I switched to a more relevant problem. The temperature lately has been crazy hot where I live. To make matters worse, the air conditioning in my car has got that weird thing where, like, it doesn't work. I needed to build an air conditioner that would take regular air from my car vents and cool it significantly. It turns out that the vents in my car are the same diameter as the inside of a can of beans. In order to get the air from the vent down into the container that I would be using for the body of the air conditioner, I had to make some ductwork by attaching bean cans to a protein powder container. I cut holes in the protein powder container and then glued the bean cans. As a side note, if you want your air conditioning to have that extra beany flavor, make sure you don't rinse the cans before you use them. I cut a hole in the top of the cat litter container and then mounted the ductwork. It turns out that when warm air comes into contact with water, it causes some of that water to evaporate, and that removes some of the energy from the air, causing it to cool down. The trick with this type of cooling is to get the air to come into contact with as much water as possible. If I simply fill the bin with room temperature water and pass air through it, there will be almost no perceivable effect on the temperature. By putting some wet newspaper into the bin, I was able to increase the amount of wet surfaces that the air was able to come into contact with, and therefore increase the amount of evaporative cooling that took place. Initially, I wanted to use the foam I had collected from all the laptop batteries I had purchased for harvesting 18650 cells. The problem is that I needed a material that would wick or pull the water upwards against the pull of gravity. When you look at this piece of foam and this piece of newspaper side by side, you can see the water traveling up the newspaper, but not up the foam. In order to use the foam, I would need to install some sort of a pump to spray water onto it, and I didn't see any good pumps in my garbage, so... The trick now was to figure out a way to maximize the amount of wet surface area that the air passing through the chamber would come into contact with, and my solution was a newspaper radiator of sorts. I designed the top of the radiator out of styrofoam and cut slots in it for mounting the strips of newspaper. There are large openings on each side, one for the air inlet and one for the outlet. The outline shape of the whole part is designed to fit inside the container. I then cut newspaper to fit the width of the slots and inserted it one piece at a time. The idea is to have the newspaper dangle straight down, wicking up the water in the base of the container and allowing air to pass between the sheets, maximizing the amount of evaporation taking place. I knew that some of the sheets of newspaper would probably cling to each other towards the bottom when they got wet, but this really isn't that bad of a solution for trash. I put a barrier between the inlet and the outlet. This way, the bean vent air only goes into one side and then passes through the wet newspaper before coming out the other side. I connected the trashy air conditioning to my vent and let the container sit in my car on a sunny day for several hours to allow the water to match the temperature of the car. This is to help prevent any false results from having water that's cold. For my first reading, the air coming out of my vents was about 83 degrees Fahrenheit, and the air coming out of the bin outlet dropped down to as low as 68.7, a 14.3 degree difference. For my second reading, the air coming out of the vents was 79.5, and the air at the bin outlet was as low as 62.7. That's almost a 17 degree difference.
Unfortunately, the volume of air being moved just wasn't enough to make a real dent in the overall temperature of my car. Also, this type of cooling is known as a swamp cooler, because although it lowers the temperature, it does so by increasing the humidity. This type of a cooling system is really great for more arid or dry climates, and I was actually really surprised to see how well it did, given the fact that it was already working with air at a 50% humidity level. Now at this point, you have got to check out my trash competitor, I Did a Thing, and leave a comment to let us know. Who do you think won? I'll even put a link to his video in the description below. Now while you're over at I Did a Thing, do yourself a favor and binge watch all of his videos, because this dude is hilarious, and the projects that he makes are super entertaining and thought-provoking, and you. No, dude, you're hilarious, you know this, right? Yeah, you. Oh, come on, look. This guy, come on. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the music and the video, and if you did, consider dropping a like and subscribing. I will see you next time.